From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis has announced additional measures which government plans to take. Among them is effective immediately. The daily curfew for mainland Abaco will be moved to 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. Previously, Abaco's curfew was 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. Additionally, travelers within the Bahamas who have been fully vaccinated against the COVID-19 virus will be exempted from COVID-19 test requirements that are currently in place when traveling from New Providence, Grand Bahama, Abaco, Exuma, and Eleuthera. Travelers will be exempted immediately after full vaccination. Proof of full vaccination will be required. Further, effective May 1st, those traveling to the Bahamas from outside the country will be exempt from a COVID-19 test if they are fully vaccinated and have passed the 2-week immunity period. Proof of full vaccination is also required. Dr. Minnis said, to be clear, if an individual is not fully vaccinated, that person will still be required to provide a negative COVID-19 test where testing requirements are in place. Bahamians are endangering their jobs, incomes, and families through resistance to taking the COVID-19 vaccine, a senior tourism official has warned yesterday in urging Bahamians to step up to the plate and get it done. Carrie Fountain, the Out Islands Promotion Board's executive director, told the Tribune that the economy's post-pandemic rebound and international competitiveness could be threatened if persons become too focused on the debate over companies seeking to make vaccination mandatory for their employees. National Security Minister Marvin Dames said he's disturbed by social media reports naming police officers as responsible for the murders of 6 men last week and cautioned the public against spreading unsubstantiated claims. While Police Commissioner Paul Roll has repeatedly said there is no evidence to suggest officers were involved in any way in the murders, photographs of 5 men believed to be officers, along with voice notes blaming them for the incident, have been making the rounds on social media. Speaking to reporters yesterday, Mr. Dames appealed to the public to be responsible as they use social media. He said the officers and their families should be taken into account. 3 Haitian male migrants found in a school bus turned into a home on Abaco were arrested and pleaded guilty to illegal landing before the magistrate's court. The Immigration Department said in a press release yesterday that the men were arraigned in court on the island before Magistrate Ancilla Evans. Officials said the men had no legal status in the country and revealed while in custody that they entered the country by boat in December 2020. Upon conviction, those migrants were ordered to remain in immigration custody for deportation, having been fined $300. Or in default of payment, serve 1 month at the Bahamas Department of Correctional Services. An official complaint was lodged with the department after a video spread on social media of a school bus turned into a dwelling home for suspected illegal migrants in the Dundas Town Abaco area. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, the Justice Department is opening a sweeping investigation into policing practices in Minneapolis after a former officer was convicted in the killing of George Floyd there, Attorney General Merrick Garland announced today. The decision comes a day after former officer Derek Chauvin was found guilty of murder and manslaughter in Floyd's death last May, setting off a wave of relief across the country. The death prompted months of mass protests against policing and the treatment of black people in the U.S. Slow out of the gate, the European Union has ramped up its COVID-19 vaccination efforts with the distribution of the Johnson & Johnson one-shot product this week, adding to the momentum amid doggedly high infection rates on the continent. The EU's vaccine drive still lags far behind that of Britain or the United States. Only about 1 in 5 of the bloc's 450 million inhabitants have received their first shot, approximately half the U.S. share, but European officials say they have turned the corner. The Tribune's AccuWeather update: a service saw of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A stalled frontal boundary just north of the area is expected to migrate through the extreme northwest Bahamas as a cold front this afternoon. Elsewhere, a dense plume of Saharan dust will continue to blanket the islands today. Mariners and residents in the northwest Bahamas are asked to exercise caution due to the risk of possible waterspout and tornadic activity and the possibility of reduced visibility across the entire country due to the presence of Saharan dust. In the northwest Bahamas, it'll be mostly cloudy, hot, and hazy, with a few scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms, mainly across the extreme northwest Bahamas today. Mostly fair and warm, with a chance of a few isolated showers tonight. Some showers may be heavy and thunderstorms strong to severe at times. Small craft operators should be alert for gusty winds and higher seas, in or near heavy showers or thunderstorms. Winds south to southwest at 10 to 15 knots, but falling light and variable at times. Seas 2 to 4 feet over over the ocean. In the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be partly to mostly sunny, hot and hazy, fair and mild tonight. Winds east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots, falling light and variable at times over open waters. Seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 74. The sun will set this afternoon at 7:33 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:42. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.